Hello friends, welcome back to VOGAS. Welcome to the discussion on daily MCQ. Today is 25th of August 2021 and now we are going to discuss 5 current affair based MCQs. So let's start. But first let us discuss the question that was asked yesterday. And yesterday's question was, which one of the following liberties is not embodied in the preamble of the Constitution of India? A. Liberty of thought. B. Liberty of belief. C. Liberty of expression. And D. Economic liberty. And some of you have given the correct answers as well. Yesterday it was Pankaj Verma, Rajesh Animireddy, Vinay Tiwari and Subham Basak who gave the correct answer. So if you see this liberties, so we have this liberty of thought, expression, belief and faith. So this option D, economic liberty, is not mentioned in the preamble. So option D is the correct answer, the economic liberty. Now we will see what are the things that are mentioned in the preamble. So if you see, this is the preamble, and guys, from the examination point of view, you have to remember this document as it is. You have to remember this document as it is. And one more important thing, what we need to remember is, in 1976, under the 42nd Constitutional Amendment Act, three words were added. They are secular, socialist, and integrity. These three words are added. Socialist, secular, and integrity. These three words were added in 1976 under the 42nd Constitutional Amendment Act. So if you see the preamble, we the people of India, having solemnly resolved to constitute India into, remember these words, sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic, and to secure its citizens, justice, which is social, economic, and political, liberty of thought, expression, belief, faith, and worship, equality of status and opportunity, and promote among them all, and fraternity, assuring the dignity and of the individual, dignity of the individual, and the unity and integrity of the nation. So this integrity also was added in the Constituent Assembly. So in our Constituent Assembly, the 26th day of November 1949, do hereby adopt it to enact and give ourselves this constitution. So that means here the objectives of the constitution are mentioned. Okay, the objectives of justice, liberty. So these are the objectives that are mentioned, and also the date of adoption of the constitution is also mentioned. Right? So this is the important thing that we need to remember from the examination point of view. Now let's move on. And guys, as you know, daily we upload high quality 5 current affair based MCQs along with their solutions in a PDF format. This PDF format can be downloaded directly from our Telegram channel at free of cost. This is to ensure that your preparation becomes more easy, and you make the best use of this initiative so that you have an edge in the prelims examination, because these MCQs are prepared by experts who have good experience in giving prelims, and also they have cleared mains as well. So make the best use of this initiative so that you have that edge. Okay, now let's see the first question. The famous slogan, one caste, one religion, one God for all, is associated to A. T.K. Varghese Vaidyan, B. Sri Narayan Guru, C. Arvindo Ghosh, and D. Swami Sahajanand Saraswati. You have to choose the correct answer. And if you see this one caste, one religion, and one God for all, this is actually given by B. Sri Narayan Guru. So Sri Narayan Guru Jayanti was recently celebrated, 167th birth anniversary. So that's where this was in use. So Sri Narayan Guru was basically a catalyst and a leader who reformed the oppressive caste system that prevailed in the society at that time when he was there. And he belonged to the Ezhwa caste, Ezhwa community. Okay, Narayan Guru had experienced discrimination from the upper caste of the society in all forms. So he gave this philosophy, he gave this famous slogan, one caste, one religion, and one God for all. And in 1888, Narayan Guru consecrated the first temple of Lord Shiva, where an idol was ordinated by a non-Brahmin in his village in Kerala. Okay, and if you see, Vaikom Satyagraha, remember this. This Vaikom Satyagraha is actually, which is a temple entry movement, and this is associated to Acharya Narayan Guru. This might be a question tomorrow. Okay, so this is all the important information. And yeah, here you can see in 1903 he established Sri Narayana Dharma Pariparan Yogam, and in 1913 he founded the Advaita Ashram at Alwar. So these are the important things that we need to remember from the examination point of view. Now let's move on. The second question, the Yuktadhara sometimes seen in the news is related to Yuktadhara, A. Geospatial Planning Portal, B. ICBM, C. Reusable Rocket Designed by ISRO, and D. Operation Flood. So we have to choose the correct answer, and the correct answer is A. Geospatial Planning Portal. So recently the Ministry of Rural Development has launched this new Geospatial Planning Portal, Yuktadhara, to help in facilitating the new MNREGA asset, so that these MNREGA assets can be geotagged and saved using this Yuktadhara portal. And it's a GIS based, that is Geographic Information System based portal, and it's a new portal under the already existing Bhuvan portal. So basically this Bhuvan portal was launched by ISRO along with the government of India. So it is a basically a geospatial platform which is used by the government for various developmental planning activities. Okay, and this Vidyatara portal, if you see, it will be a repository of assets which are developed under the MNREGA, because normally what is happening is under MNREGA a lot of works are being done but they are not geotagged, so duplication of work is being happening, and also there are a lot of corruption and a lot of other issues that are there. Sometimes they say that the work has happened but in reality the work will not be happening. So all of these issues can be solved using this Yuktadhara portal. So remember, Yuktadhara portal is related to MNREGA, and it will integrate a variety of thematic layers like multi-temporal high resolution earth observation data with analytic tools. So that means real-time information, that is real-time images, also will be there under this Yuktadhara portal. So basically only those activities which are being worked, or you can say the activities which have happened, can only be tagged, because this can be monitored real time, what is happening and what has happened also. So even the previous images can be compared with the existing images. Okay, so this is all the information about Yuktadhara portal. Now let's move on to the next question. Third question: consider the following place. So there are places in use and their countries or location is given. First one is Tristan da Cunha, second one Panjshir Valley, third one Al-Aqsa Mosque, and the countries given are Myanmar, India, Jerusalem. So we have to choose which pairs are correctly matched. So here, if you see the Tristan da Cunha, so Tristan is basically it's an island in the Atlantic Ocean and it belongs to the British. So the first one is wrong. And second one, if you see the Panjshir Valley, this Panjshir Valley is located in Afghanistan. So recently this was in news. So that's why the second option, which is given as India, is wrong. And third one, if you see the Al-Aqsa Mosque is there in Jerusalem. So C3 only is the correct answer. So this Afghan Taliban crisis is happening, and from the examination point of view, we have to remember all the important places that are surrounding Afghanistan. We have to remember the important rivers and the countries surrounding Afghanistan as well. Okay, so this Panjshir Valley is in news recently, and it is a valley in the north central Afghanistan near the Hind Kush mountain region, and it is divided into Panjshir River, divided by the Panjshir River, and the valley is home to the ethnic tribes called the Tajiks. Okay, so this region has more Tajiks. And if you see this Tristan da Cunha, it is the largest isolated UK overseas territory. Okay, that is there in Atlantic Ocean. It's a fully protected marine reserve, which is about 6,87,000 square kilometers. It is not the largest, but it is a overseas territory of UK. And the Al-Aqsa Mosque is there in Jerusalem. So remember these things: Al-Aqsa Mosque in Jerusalem. Okay, so that's why the Jerusalem is a famous place, both for the Christians as well as the Muslims, because there are churches for the Christians as well as mosques for the Muslims. Okay, now let's look at the next question, the fourth question. The children's climate risk index is released by A. IUCN, B. UNICEF, C. World Economic Forum, and D. Niti Aayog. So here the correct answer is UNICEF. The Children Climate Risk Index is released by UNICEF, and recently this new report is published, and it has said that children in India are at extreme high risk of the impacts of the climate crisis. India is among the 33 extremely high risk countries where children are most at risk of climate change affecting their health and education, and it ranks India at vulnerable 26th rank, and it is among the four South Asian nations such as Pakistan, Bangladesh and Afghanistan which are at very high risk. Okay, so remember, the Children Climate Risk Index is released by UNICEF, United Nations International Children Emergency Fund. Right? Now let's move on. The fifth question: the corals can be found in which of the following locations in India? First one, Gulf of Mannar. Second one, Andaman Nicobar Islands. Third one, Lakshadweep. And fourth one, Malwan. So we have to choose the correct answer. And here the correct answer is D, 1, 2, 3 and 4. In all these four locations, in the Gulf of Mannar, in the Andaman Nicobar Islands, in the Lakshadweep, as well as in the Malwan. So the Malwan is there in Maharashtra. So in all of these locations, we can find the corals. So any question on corals is very much important from the examination point of view. So just focus on it. Actually, why this was in news is, a new study has identified for the first time that specialized immune cells, the phagocytic cells, exist in certain varieties of sea corals and anemones. And what is this phagocytosis? It is a process by which certain living cells called phagocytes ingest or engulf other cells or particles. The phagocyte may be a free living or one-celled organism like amoeba, or one of the body cells such as the white blood cell. Okay, so this was recently identified. And if you see the corals, they are generally made up of identical organisms called polyps, the coral polyps. And these polyps have microscopic algae which are living inside their tissues. They are called as zooxanthellae. The zooxanthellae is the algae. So they have a mutual relationship, mutualistic. That means the coral polyps provide food for them, and the zooxanthellae, they also provide important vitamins and minerals for the corals. They also provide that calcium and other things for the coral polyp, for the corals to be that strong, and also they provide that color to the corals. So that's why during this crisis or during the climate change and all, what is happening is this algae is dying and the corals are losing their color. The corals are losing their color, so that's the important reason why we have this discoloration of corals, because these algae dies. Okay, and the corals and algae have mutualistic relationship, which we already discussed. And the coral reefs in India are present in areas like Gulf of Kutch, the Gulf of Mannar, the Andaman and Nicobar Islands, Lakshadweep Islands, and Malwan. Okay, so now let's look at the question of the day. The question of the day is, which one of the following liberties? Yeah, this is yesterday's question, and we look at today's question. Which organization releases the Global Climate Risk Index? Global Climate Risk Index: A. WHO, B. UNICEF, C. World Economic Forum, and D. NGO German Watch. You have to give your answer in the comment box. So today we have discussed already the Children Climate Risk Index, and this is Global Climate Risk Index. Okay, do give your answer in the comment box, and tomorrow we will discuss this question. So guys, these are our initiatives. We have launched Vision PT 365 summary, Vision Prelims Test Series summary, Vision Monthly Magazine summary, and Vision Mains Test Series summary. These summaries will help in your preparation, and they will ease your preparation as well. So do make the best use of these initiatives, and if you have any doubt, you can get back to us via comments, or you can get back to us via Telegram as well. The Telegram channel details I'll give in the description. So that's it, friends, for the day. I'll see you again tomorrow with 5 more MCQs. Till then, keep studying and stay tuned. Jai Hind.